ξέσπασαν πρωτοφανείς διαμαρτυρίες για τα δεδομένα της χώρας. Για πρώτη φορά μετά το Δεύτερο Παγκόσμιο Πόλεμο, οι διαδηλωτές στο Ρέικιαβικ ήρθαν αντιμέτωποι με τα δακρυγόνα της αστυνομίας.
Before the financial crash, the Icelandic people didn't give a damn about politics. They didn't think about this. Everything was just going fine. And we did, like people in Europe, we just went voting every time, every fourth year, and then we went home again and we didn't think about it so much. Then the crash comes and all of a sudden people are engaging themselves. They are thinking about the society. They are saying, why did that happen? How could that happen?
Οι διαδηλώσεις έφεραν αποτέλεσμα. Η κυβέρνηση εξαναγκάστηκε σε παρέτηση. Εκλέχθηκε μια νέα, με τη συμμαχία Κέντρο Αριστεράς και Αριστεράς. Αυτή η κυβέρνηση το πρώτο που έκανε ήταν να δει πώς θα αποζημιώσει τους ξένους καταθέτες. Άρχισε να διαπραγματεύεται με το Ηνωμένο Βασίλειο και την Ολλανδία για τους όρους αποπληρωμής των χρεών που οι ιδιωτικές εταιρείες, οι τράπεζες δηλαδή, είχαν δημιουργήσει. Η συμφωνία υπερψηφίστηκε από το κοινοβούλιο και πήγε στον πρόεδρο της χώρας, τον κύριο Όλαφουρ Γκρίμσον, για επικύρωση. Ο πρόεδρος όμως αρνήθηκε να την υπογράψει και κάλεσε σε δημοψήφισμα.
It was a question of whether the ordinary people of Iceland, farmers and fishermen and nurses and doctors and young people and old people, should be made responsible for the failure of a private bank. To put it differently, do we have a system where the success of the banks leads to great profit for the shareholders and big bonuses for the bankers, but the failure of the banks leads to higher taxes by ordinary people? Do we nationalize the losses, but privatize the profits?
Η Ευρωζώνη γίνεται έξαλλη με την απόφαση του Ισλανδού Προέδρου.
The Icelandic people, if they were to reach that conclusion, would effectively be saying that Iceland doesn't want to be part of the international financial system, that Iceland doesn't want to have access to multinational, national and bilateral funding, and doesn't want to be regarded as a safe counterparty with whom to do business. I don't think the Icelandic people would be sensible if they reached that conclusion. So we will work with other governments to support the Icelandic government in getting the necessary referendum support.
Στη χώρα του, ο πρόεδρος κατηγορήθηκε από το μεγαλύτερο μέρος της πολιτικής τάξης για λαϊκισμό.
No, it was not populistic at all, even on the contrary, because the opposition to my decision when I took it in the early days of 2010 was enormous and widespread. Majority of the parliament, the government parties, the ministers, many of my biggest supporters who helped to make me president in 1996 were absolutely furious at my decision. Every government in Europe was against my decision. There were all kind of predictions that this would lead to the isolation of Iceland, to the collapse of Iceland. We would be a pariah state in the world. Some people used the concept of the Cuba of the North, and so on and so forth.
Ήταν το πρώτο δημοψήφισμα που διοργανώθηκε ποτέ στην Ισλανδία. Οι πολίτες κλήθηκαν να αποφασίσουν για το αν θα πρέπει να πληρώσουν οι ίδιοι τη ζημιά που είχαν προκαλέσει οι τράπεζες.
We were just supposed to say yes, we pay. For what? For a private company that was really bad run. I mean, that is not my fault and nobody's fault. It's the fault of the owner of the company. And the people of Iceland said no.
You come to those crossroads that on the one hand are the demands of the financial market and on the other is the democratic will of the people. My answer was that, of course, faced with such a choice, we have to go with the democratic will of the people. Because what is Europe's greatest contribution to civilization? It's not the market economy, it's democracy, which is Europe's greatest contribution to the world. There are countries in present times that have very strong market economies, but very little democracy. So when we come to those crossroads that we are forced to choose, my answer, when all the analysis had been swept away, was crystal clear that the democratic will of the people had to prevail.